The North Dakota Chamber of Commerce doesn't like its name. Not the name of the chamber, the name of the state. They think the name North Dakota connotes someplace freezing cold. They want to change it to just Dakota, which they feel has a nice Wild West twang to it. A lot of comedians are having a lot of fun with this. David Letterman suggested that North Dakota change its name, but make some money doing it. You know how arenas and stadiums are now selling their names? He suggested they sell it to Coca-Cola. Then the state could be called Coca-Cola Dakota. The proposal to drop the word North is being taken quite seriously, however, by, North Dakotans. A bill has been proposed in the state legislature. Businesses are lobbying for it. But if it goes through and gets made into law, there will be all sorts of trouble, particularly down in Washington. The thing is, there is no find and replace button to help the bureaucrats in Washington. There are federal funds that are supposed to go to North Dakota. There are official anthems and flags that say North Dakota. There is the University of North Dakota. Where is this stuff now supposed to go? Would North Dakota lose its status as a state and become a man without a country until it could be re-voted in? As for South Dakota, the governor of that state says he thinks the whole thing's ridiculous. But he's in South Dakota. They've got palm trees and pelicans in South Dakota. North Dakota is the land of the penguins. Or so it would seem to anyone else in the United States who doesn't live in North Dakota. When you look at a map of America, you know that the farther north you go, the colder it gets. Maine is cold, Idaho and Montana are cold, North Dakota is cold. All of them are just bumping up against the ceiling of the United States of America, and they are cold as hell. And wind chills are minus 48. Once I had a dream about getting on an airplane, flying over South Dakota, flying over North Dakota, and then going further north from the freezingest, coldest part of the lower 48 to Banff. I had never been to Banff. Banff was in Canada. Banff was even colder than the coldest part of Montana. How could this be? You went south and it got warmer until you got to Montana? It couldn't get any colder than Montana, could it? In the dream, I got on this plane to go to Banff because there was supposed to be some sort of weekend-long newspaper publishers convention there. We landed in a blizzard and 10 feet of snow, and I was hustled off in a snowmobile to this virtual ghost town where in the lobby of an abandoned hotel with snow blowing through the broken windows, I was told the convention had been canceled. The next plane out? Not for another 5 days. Sorry, I woke up. Personally, I think whoever it is on the North Dakota Chamber of Commerce who has fired the imagination of the state is a New Yorker. 150 years ago in New York City, everything above 42nd Street was farmland. Below 42nd Street, there were big buildings, fortunes made and lost, busy executives, and one of them at that time thought that way up there north of 42nd Street in the boonies, there should be a grand hotel. He built it, and he named it, surrounded by farms as it was, the Dakota, as in way the hell up in Dakota. It's still the Dakota today, though they've built up the neighborhood and the name doesn't fit anymore. Anyway, this New Yorker brought the idea with him when he moved to Fargo. I've been searching my mind for ideas for other places that might consider changing their names. One that comes to mind, oddly, is New York itself. York is a place in England. We here in America borrowed it and put the new in front of it because those here at the time had fond memories of the old place and thought it would surely keep the memory of it alive. This is surely, for a first-rate town, a really second-rate hand-me-down name. That we have a deaf ear to this problem can be proven by a test which I am now going to give you. What does Old New York bring to mind? An old part of New York, right? That there are two words here that ought to just cancel each other out has gone right over your head, right? Saigon became Ho Chi Minh City when North Vietnam beat South Vietnam. We should have changed New York when we drove the British out in 1783. It's too late now. Here on the East End, there have been numerous attempts, some successful, some not so successful, to change the names of towns so they include the magic word Hamptons. Around 1880, the town of Good Ground successfully changes its name to Hampton Bays. There is, to this day, a store on Main Street in that town with the name Good Ground carved in stone on the second floor. They'll never get it off. Good Ground, a very good name, will live forever. In 1985, the lower middle-class town of Mastic Beach, between Shirley and Yaphank, petitioned the authorities to allow them to change their name to Hampton Beach. the plan got hooted out of the state legislature. Perhaps the most interesting story about a community out here wanting to change its name came in 1885, when a group of wealthy New York summer people with homes in Shinnecock Hills got together and decided they'd like to change the name of the place to Hampton Hills. Lawyers looked into it and found that for this change to take place, there had to be a majority vote of the permanent residents of Shinnecock Hills favoring the change presented to the state legislature. There were no permanent residents, but then one of the summer people remembered one. This was Mr. Terwilliger, the postmaster, who stayed out here year-round and forwarded all their mail to them in the off-season. He had an office in the Shinnecock Hills Railroad Station, where he had a second job as that of station master for the Long Island Railroad. A contingent of summer people went to see Mr. Terwilliger and asked him if he would vote to change Shinnecock Hills to Hampton Hills. "Nope," he said, and that was the end of that.